is 3 based on the percentage. Anyway, simple neural networks are not perfect. They are not too incomplete, so you're unable to make all the operations unlike other programs that's been written by human. I mean, it's been written by human, of course, but it's continuing writing itself by itself. So anyway, there was another innovation, regular neural networks. They kind of solved this problem with not being too incomplete by adding a hidden layer, a kind of short memory. So there was they were able to do the stuff like fed the program the word hello. So it will be able when the next time will be put the letter L. It would suggest to put an O if there was before another L, or another L if there was before E, and so on. Okay. Also, recurrent neural networks are an infrastructure, are widely being used in translations from one language to another, and in translations, text-to-speech. There is also another field where it's been used. It has been used, if you can remember, by the guys from Yandex to create an album in style of Гражданская оборона. It was called Neuronная оборона. They basically fed the lyrics of Ерлетов to the program, and it gave away another lyrics, kind of in his style. So those another innovation, the next step, neural Turing machines. They kind of solved almost all the problems that RNN system had. I mean, RNN system were Turing complete, but they had a problem of complete usage of memory. And basically, it was like they were unable to distinguish types of data measure. So they didn't know on its own what the difference between kilograms and kilometers. It had to be written in its architecture. But with this innovation, they kind of just, the biggest thing they did, they just separated the controller and memory, and that allowed everything. Okay. And the last innovation was made quite recently by Google, about one and a half year ago. It's the transport neural computers, DNC for short. It's kind of had the same architecture that the neural Turing machine, but it was more flexible and more user-friendly. And also it got new conceptions. Neural Turing machine was only able to remember things. This thing is able to, this thing also got selective attention, contextual search, recall by association, and forgetting. All this thing is called soft attention, which is basically means that all the data is being written everywhere at the same time, but the amount of change declared by the amount of attention given to the cells, or the squares, if you like to call them that. Okay, also there were a couple of tests made by different organizations. The first test was made by Facebook. It's quite a famous test. It's a test on understanding the text. It sounded like that. John went to the garden, Mary took a bottle of milk, John returned home. Where is John? So the program was supposed to answer this question without any preparation, without any help. And there was only about 4% of failures in RNC system, and about 7.5% in other systems. So there is also another test which is called penalty. The program was given a couple of connection between close relatives, and it was supposed to find the relatives with much longer connection. someone's uncle and so on. It's going to be a show very soon. So, in conclusion, I would like to say that it may seem quite easy, but it's really a good thing because the program is being written on its own. So you don't have to spend a lot of time to program it by yourself, and it's quite a great invention, and it's being used very widely nowadays. Okay, I think that's it. Thank you very much. You can ask questions if you want.
Yeah, well, thank you very much. Very interesting. So, well, if I have a right to ask a question. As you are the last speaker, we've seen a lot of, insights of the future during our during the presentations. And how do you think all those insights, Internet of Things and gadgets and neural networks that were mentioned a few times, how do you think they will interconnect in the future? How will they work with each other?
Well, I think neural networks are probably going to be used more widely than now. I mean, it's quite used nowadays, and every one of you have a T9 on your phone, which helps you to write a text and looks for your mistakes and so on. I think it's going to be used as a help device almost in every field. Like, I don't believe it's even going to be used in robots. This thing itself isn't intelligent, but I do believe it's going to be used in robotics here to create artificial intelligence as a helping device.
Thank you for your answer. Any more questions?
Mm-hmm. Okay. I always ask, and sometimes don't understand, what's in the name? Yeah, so neural networks. What do they have to do with a neuron? A Turing machine, like, it isn't the primitive machine Turing constructed, so it's some kind of a concept. Why it's called a Turing machine? What's the similarity?
It's called Turing machine, first of all, because, as I mentioned, basically, in Turing machine, there is control and memory, they're separated. So the same thing does this new neural network, which basically solves a lot of problems. And about neural thing, there is these squares, which are called neurons in terms of the programming. And it's just numbers. It didn't have to be negative, it didn't have to be positive only or negative only numbers. And they're gonna keep the info in. And they are changed just like neurons by the data that comes later on.
Is the question answered? Good. Well, I have one more question, if you may. So, can you please go back a little? Yeah, and more back. Back to this. Yeah, here. So, it's a great example, but those numbers, they don't seem to add up to 100.
I mean, it's not like yin and yang, but it's a chance of. It's any going to be total 100. It's 79% of it's being the dream, and other percentage like 21 is percent of it's not being the dream. It's comparing this with each other picture, like how many percentage of squares the same with 3, and the same with 5, 2, 9, 0, and so on.
Any more questions? Well, that's it for now with the speakers. So.